Inner Traditions Audio presents When God Had a Wife, The Fall and Rise of the Sacred Feminine in the Judeo-Christian Tradition by Lynn Picknett and Clive Prince. Read by Theresa Widmann. To the new arrivals and looking toward a more goddess-friendly future, Isaac Samuel Brown, Leonardo Milani Ferris, Aurora Elizabeth Beskin Schofield, Ada Iona Fearnley Hennison. Acknowledgments. Our heartfelt thanks are due to many people. Bali Beskin, whose friendship, inspiration, and drive made this book possible. And special thanks, too, to Geraldine Beskin and Dr. Stephen Schofield, also of the Magical Atlantis Bookshop in London. Thank you for all the giggles, deep discussions, special evenings, fascinating introductions, and certain very big birthdays. Our lovely friend Karina Fearnley for being such an amazingly supportive, kind, and fun star. Thanks too to her partner Jack Hannison. As ever, our agent Jeffrey Simmons for believing in this book, the team at Bear & Company for making it real, John Graham, John Hayes, Patricia Rydell, Jenny Marks, Kelly Bowen, Erica B. Robinson, and Manzanita Carpenter Sons. The effervescent, funny, and kind Helen Scott, whose light shone so brightly in our darkest days, and who has been taken from us so tragically. She will always be much missed. For always being there for us with helpful suggestions, jolly distractions, fabulous conversations, and genial generosity. Debbie and Yvonne Cartwright, Jane Lyle, Mike Wallington, Javier and Eva Sierra, Sheila Taylor, Keith Prince, Chris Murray, Cinziana Paduro, Graham Phillips, Corrine Esperiel, John and Judith Rimmer, Kevin and Noyumi Murphy, Trevor Pine, and all our fellow Magonians, Gary Lockman, Hannah Johnson, and Stu Braun, John and Caitlin Matthews, Andrew Collins, Magister Cygnus, Sharon and Phil Jagger, Dan O'Connell, Eleanor Julie, and Ian Duxbury Wilson, Maura Hardcastle, Greg Ratty, Bobby Sullivan, Steffi Grant, the late great Guy Leon Playfair, Mike Playfair, Ashley Brown, Stuart Ferris and Katia Milani, Heather Cooper, Nigel Henbest, the late fabulous Ian Dugan, Chris Warwick, Carrie Kirkpatrick, Dr. Robert Feather, Sheila Andrews, and Darren Roberts, Tessa Harris, Veronica and Alan Goodrode, Stu Barker, Mark Friedman, Jean and Jim Bodie, Ronald Hendrickson, Max D. Crapo, Ellie Chamberlain, Jack Sarfati, Sally Morgan, Bruce Burgess, David Elkington, Duina Gibb, Ken Graydon, Joy and Chris Millar, Caroline Brown, Kimberly Humberstone, and Robbie Bridgestock. For invaluable research assistance, the staff at the British Library. Introduction, Bringing Her Back Home. Every book represents a new and exciting journey, not just for the reader, but also for the authors themselves. In our case, When God Had a Wife not only took us into unexplored territories, which we would expect, but also revisited some of the key themes of our previous books. But this time we found a sharper message and many more tantalizing questions, some very big indeed. After all, few nonfiction topics can be quite as intriguing as the deliberate near eradication of the sacred feminine in the two great religions of Judaism and Christianity. But surely even more astonishing is the fact that they had a goddess figure in the first place. As some listeners will know, this theme has been close to our hearts for decades, but there was more to investigate, more loose ends to tie up, more revelations to uncover. The goddess never yields her secrets easily, but she allows glimpses, often through the most unlikely sources. It is never impossible to trace her survival, though there are still those who hate that ancient cover-ups are being exposed and especially loathe the comeback of the goddess. We know how the patriarchies react because we have already felt the cold wind of their disapproval and the even sharper bite of real hostility. Indeed, this book is something of a prequel to our controversial The Masks of Christ, Behind the Lies and Cover-ups About the Man Believed to Be God, published in 2008, which in turn dug deeper into subjects at the heart of our The Templar Revelation, Secret Guardians of the True Identity of Christ, published in 1997, revised and updated in 2007. This book also fits snugly into the arc of Lynn's solo works, Mary Magdalene, Christianity's Hidden Goddess, published in 2003, and The Secret History of Lucifer, The Ancient Path to Knowledge and the Real Da Vinci Code, published in 2005. This book sees us return to the sacred feminine in the Hebrew religion, which we touched on in both earlier books, especially Templar Revelation, because it was so central to their main subject, Jesus and the origins of Christianity. But now, even we are amazed at the extent and clarity of the whole picture as we reconstructed it, excitedly, piece by piece. In the decade after Masks of Christ, our ongoing research has revealed Christ himself was heavily involved with the Holy Feminine, which helps explain some of his enduring mysteries. These include the strange mix of Jewish and pagan, especially Egyptian, elements in his mission. Previously, our attempts to reconcile them stopped short of completely closing the gap. Now we hope we have done just that, shedding further light on our previous conclusions, especially those in Templar Revelation. What were once maddeningly elusive pieces are now back in the puzzle, and the picture is startlingly different. We were not, however, alone on this journey. Knowledge is power. One might feel a profoundly spiritual and emotional response to the goddess, but this is not doing her complete justice. Spirit is powerful, but it is not everything. We only know her names, titles, and attributes, and what she meant to which ancient peoples through the accumulation of hard facts. We have always loved the goddess, but sometimes she is lost and needs finding with both the heart and mind. Over the years, we have come to respect the archaeologist who excavated ancient sites, the academics who painstakingly analyzed data, and the professors whose landmark research has been ignored for decades. Part of our mission is to build a bridge between the mind, body, and spirit community and academics. We realize the time is right to share the curious, not always easy, crossover between their discoveries and ours. Lynn discovered the value of research the hard way. As a girl, she fell into the clutches of a world-famous cult, experiencing the euphoria of conversion. But discovering the truth about the cult's founder and its historical claims soon brought her down to earth. As the Bible says, the truth shall make you free. Sadly, but understandably, there has been a great distrust between the two communities. The mind-body-spirit community, henceforth referred to as MBS, often regards academia as over-conservative, obsessed with cold facts, and far too materialistic. Scholars tend to dismiss the MBS community as naive, basing their worldview on wishful thinking and oversimplification. To us, however, both sides are partly wrong, and both sides are partly right. It's time to bring them together in the spirit of mutual respect. While we personally are by no means skeptical about the unexplained or the spiritual realm, not to mention information from outside academia, we have always realized that data from all sources must be checkable. Otherwise, any case stands little chance of being totally persuasive.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.